Welcome back to the GCP Mindset Channel. Today, we'll talk about one term that's recently popped up everywhere, on newspapers and all sorts of media, especially since the beginning of COVID-19 vaccinations. Adverse events, or AEs, are terms that are extremely important for every clinical study, and we hope we can shed some light on these terms. And what do they mean? Let's dive in.
What everybody, really everybody, should know.
Interest in clinical research has increased significantly recently, and everyone currently dealing with the COVID-19 vaccinations will have repeatedly come across two important terms: adverse events and serious adverse events. Let's start with adverse events. Patient safety is paramount in clinical research. Every time a new drug is tested on people, special emphasis is placed on how the drug affects the state of health and what undesirable effects can occur. As soon as a pharmaceutical product is administered to a patient or clinical investigation subject within a study, all adverse events must be recorded, even if there is no causal relationship with the treatment. Let's look at the definition of an adverse event. An adverse event is any untoward medical occurrence, whether expected or unexpected, any sign, including significant abnormal laboratory findings, which is considered clinically significant. This can also be any symptom, any disease, or even any worsened, diagnostically changed condition after administration of the investigational product, such as an increased heart rate or a decrease in blood pressure. This is always an adverse event. Also, any increase in frequency or occurrence or intensity of an already existing condition, for example, a headache, also falls under the definition of an AE, as well as any worsening of a pre-existing illness documented in the medical history. So, what's not an adverse event? The mere persistence of pre-existing illnesses or conditions already present before the enrollment must not be documented as an adverse event if there's no change or worsening of the condition. In the same way, events that occur beyond the time window of the study, such as events prior to the initiation of the study treatment, they're not assessed as AEs. Exceptions are events associated with study-related procedures, such as blood sampling. In cases where the subject is asymptomatic, overdoses of a study medication or concomitant medications are not allowed to be documented as adverse events. It's important to note that it is always the events which induce an intervention, but should not be documented as an AE and not the intervention itself. Therefore, medical or surgical interventions are not considered to be adverse events, but rather the condition making the intervention necessary. A typical example is that many investigators have previously documented a tooth extraction as an adverse event instead of the reason for the tooth extraction, for example, inflammation of the tooth. Let's explain a final example to make clear why it's so important that all AEs have to be documented in a study, even if it seems that there is no causal relationship with the study drug or the study itself. Often, unrelated events, considered collectively, ultimately indicate adverse reactions. Try to think of a multi-center diabetes study where the patients get insulin. In that study, one patient of a certain site is working as a construction worker, and one day, at work, he falls from a scaffolding, ultimately dying from his injuries. The death of this construction worker was considered as unrelated to the study medication by the investigators. Nevertheless, this incident was recorded as an adverse event. A second patient from another site is a good swimmer and goes swimming nearly every morning, but one day has an accident and dies in the pool. The investigator thinks that dying in the pool is not related to the study or study drug, but also documents the event as an AE. A third patient participating in the study often jogs, and one day on one of his runs, he has an accident and falls, injuring his knee. This is also an AE, even if the investigator thinks that there is no relationship between the knee injury and the study medication. Finally, all the recorded AEs show that there are several patients in the study that are having accidents caused by an overdose of insulin. So, all these accidents have a direct relationship with the study drug. They're not only an AE, but also an adverse drug reaction of the study drug at a certain dosing. This shows clearly that not a single investigator can decide if an AE is drug-related. All these incidents have to be documented as AEs. Only after review of all the data will it show if there is a relationship to the study drug. Therefore, investigators have to understand that it is important that everything be documented correctly, even if it initially seems that there's no obvious relationship. We hope this example makes the importance of AE documentation and what an AE is much clearer. Thank you so much for watching our video about adverse events. Stay tuned, our next video is about a more serious topic, serious adverse events. Take care.